In preparation for modular pole assembly, ensure the ground is relatively level. Use pole stands, assembly racks, or wood dunnage to get the modules at a good working height. Position the two modules such that they are relatively level with one another and align for assembly. Wipe down the overlap areas, the inside of the upper module and the outside of the lower module, so that these areas are clear of any dirt, ice, or other debris in the slip joint overlap area. Align the modules with the pre-printed B-axis facing up. The alignment lines are printed on the B-axis along the length of the module. Match up the alignment lines on the two modules with each other. Be mindful of pinch points when aligning the poles. Hands should be placed on the outside of the upper module. Use caution if the module is wet because the surface will be slippery. For smaller modules, you can manually maneuver the base of the upper module over the tip of the larger lower module until the slip joint overlap becomes snug and the two modules begin to align as one unit. Be careful to maintain the alignment of the B axis. For larger and heavier modules, use a boom truck with a sling attached at the center of gravity. The COG is printed on each module prior to shipping. However, be careful as the top module is often cut to length, so the COG marking will not be correct, and the COG should be established prior to handling. Be sure to inspect the jacking bars for any damage before use, as they will be under intense pressure. Once the joints are snug, insert the two jacking bars into the pre-drilled holes, one at the base of the upper module and the other at the tip of the larger lower module. Slide a loose jacking plate onto each jacking bar. Then, slide on the retention collar, with the flange side of the collar oriented towards the pole. Prior to inserting the quick release pin, rotate the retention collar to identify the best suited set of holes that will keep the collar tight up against the jacking plate, and the jacking plate tight up against the pole wall. It is important that the retention collar be as tight as possible against the jacking plate and the pole wall. The jacking plates need to be as tight as possible against the pole wall. If the gap between the pole wall and the back of the jacking plate exceeds an eighth of an inch or 3 millimeters, the significant force applied during slip joint assembly may result in bending one or both jacking bars, making them difficult to remove and reuse again in the future. Connect the 2-ton lever chain hoist to the jacking plates. If required, use chain extensions or slings if the chain does not reach the jacking plates. Apply light tension using the lever chain hoists. If necessary, reposition the jacking plates such that they are all aligned in the direction of the assembly force and ensure the jacking plates are tight up against the pole wall. Be sure to use 2 2-ton hoists on each side of the pole. Begin applying force simultaneously on each side of the pole using the lever chain hoists. Keep the lever of the hoist facing outward with the flush side of the hoist against the pole wall. Maintain the module alignment throughout assembly by continuing to apply even force to both sides. As the assembly force increases and the slip joint becomes tight, use a dead blow rubber mallet to strike the overlap area to alleviate any built-up static friction. Monitor the 4 jacking holes and stop applying force if any of these holes elongate more than 1/16 of an inch or 2 millimeters. A slight amount of elongation is normal and is a sign that an appropriate level of assembly force has been applied. Compressing the slip joint is complete when 4,000 pounds of force per side has been applied and all static friction has been released by striking the overlap area with a dead blow hammer. 95% of assembled slip joints will reach to within plus or minus 1 inch or 25 millimeters of the target assembly line as marked on the lower module. Due to the resin-rich surface of RS poles, there are subtle variations in the outside diameters of each module that causes the overlap to vary from slip joint to slip joint. This results in about 5% of assembled slip joints exceeding plus or minus 1 inch or 25 millimeters from the target assembly line, despite the application of 4,000 pounds of force. Remove the lever chain hoist and the jacking bars, and the pole is ready to be mechanically secured with 2 blind nut assemblies installed at each slip joint.